Let's talk about angina pectoris or angina. Basically, angina pectoris is pain caused by inadequate blood flow to the heart. It's also due to a decrease of oxygen, specifically the myocardium. Now for the NCLEX, it is important to know that with angina, it is usually described as a squeezing, heavy discomfort pressure within the chest. Obviously, chest pain is the number one symptom, but it can also be a substernal pain that can radiate to the neck, the jaw, and the back. There are different types of angina, but I want to talk specifically about silent angina, because with silent angina, it's usually asymptomatic and it's associated with diabetes and hypertension. Now, you have to keep in mind that the EKG for angina will show an ST segment depression and a T wave inversion. The ST segment and the T wave discrepancy, it represents an abnormality in the ventricular repolarization, right? Now this goes back to the fact that during an angina there is an ischemia and there's a decrease of oxygen that is being given to the heart. So what can we do for a patient with angina? We could administer oxygen 4 to 6 liters as prescribed or as ordered. We can also give the patient a vasodilator. The drug of choice is nitroglycerin, right? A vasodilator basically it helps with the coronary artery vasospasms. It also reduces the preload and the afterload of the heart, in which it decreases the myocardial oxygen demand of the heart, right? Now, with nitroglycerin specifically, we hold it if the blood pressure is less than 90 millimeters of mercury, right? So we don't give the patient nitroglycerin if the blood pressure is less than 90. With nitroglycerin, we need to make sure that we store the tablets in a dark bottle because the light can lessen its efficiency. We also tell the patient that we place the nitroglycerin tablet under the tongue, right? We don't take it with fluid, and the patient can have up to 3 tablets 5 minutes apart. 5 minutes apart, up to 3 tablets, and if there still is no relief, then we need to take the patient to the hospital. The side effects for nitroglycerin includes burning or tingling in the mouth, dizziness, flushing, some headache, heavy sweating, nausea, and vomiting. Thank you so much for checking out my videos. For more NCLEX stuff, please visit me at allnursingnotes.com. That's allnursingnotes.com. And don't forget to join the NCLEX 26 course, in which I will show you how you can productively and systematically study and pass the NCLEX within a 26-hour time span. Let's face it, studying for the NCLEX can be tedious, boring, and draining. The NCLEX 26 course is simple, straight to the point, linear way of studying that will help you pass the NCLEX. The course will also include the audio review, in which you can listen in your car or on your headphones and listen anywhere. Thank you and good luck.